वी आर यूजिंग द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड टू क्रिएट रेजोनेंस इफेक्ट, देयर आफ्टर वी आर गोइंग टू जनरेट द इमेजेस. द मेन थिंग इज रेजोनेटिंग इफेक्ट. Now the second part that we have discussed is precision. Precision of hydrogen atoms. Suppose we are assuming one hydrogen atom in which we have one electron and one proton in the nucleus. There is zero neutron in the hydrogen atom. If we are removing this electron, it will be like hydrogen H plus proton. In the books you will also see the term proton. Protons are normally mentioned. So we can use a hydrogen atom or protons. Whenever the charged particles are kept in the magnetic field, suppose there is a B magnetic field in which I am putting this charged particle. Suppose this is our hydrogen proton we kept inside the magnetic field B. So there is a magnetic moment. This hydrogen atom will behave as a teeny magnet. It will behave as a teeny magnet and it is having a magnetic moment when it is kept inside the magnetic field. And we are denoting with this vector inside the magnet. It will be aligned in the direction of main magnetic field. Let us take an example of a top. This is the Earth gravitation. Whenever a top is moving, if you will see the movement of a top, it moves like this. And gradually it's moving like this. This movement is called precession. This top is doing precession under the influence of a gravitational force, Earth gravitational force. This movement is called precession. And at the same time, this top is also rotating on its own axis, that is called spin and precession. And the precision frequency we denoting as a omega. Precision frequency is proportional to the magnetic field in which the hydrogen atoms are kept. If we'll remove this proportional sign, so frequency is constant times B. This is a very important relation we have to remember while learning MRI. So whenever we are keeping this hydrogen atom in the magnetic field, if the field is high, the precision will also be high. Suppose for 1.5 Tesla systems, the precision frequency for hydrogen is 63 MHz. For 3 Tesla systems, the precision frequency for hydrogen is just double, 126 megahertz. So, means the whenever the field strength is increasing, whenever the field strength is increasing, suppose this is a magnetic field B, whenever the strength is increasing, this hydrogen atom is aligned in that same magnetic field with, this is the hydrogen atom, it has its own magnetic moment, and this is the main magnetic field B. So this hydrogen will start precessing. This moment is called precession. I'll show you in the next videos, I'll show you a precessing hydrogen video. So this is the precessing effect. Another point is, you would have heard about the relation, like 1 Tesla is equal to 10,000 Gauss. If you will derive it, there is also an important relation. Like if 1 Tesla is equal to 10,000 Gauss, you would have heard about 5 Gauss line. That is 0.5 millitesla. If a MR scanner is installed, suppose this is 3 Tesla and this is 1.5 Tesla. There will be a 5 Gauss line. This is a safety line here and here. These lines are called 5G lines. At this point, from a certain distance from the isocenter, the effect is 0.5 millitesla. This is called 5 Gauss line. If you are coming closer, if you are crossing this line and coming closer to the magnetic vicinity with a pacemaker or with a battery operated device, it is going to be at risk. In 1.5 Tesla, this distance may be smaller. You can get the details in the planning guides of different companies' manuals, will get this distance, but this line is called 5 Gauss lines. This is very important for the project engineers, service engineers, and for the operators also to learn what is exactly this 5 Gauss line. Thank you.